Allama Iqbal was born on November 9, 1877 in Sialkot, a small town of Punjab, India, now present day is a beautiful province of Pakistan. He belonged to a religious literary family. He has five siblings and he was the eldest amongst all. Being an eldest child, he understands his responsibilities that lies on him. He has huge interest in learning new languages including Persian, Urdu and English. He was too young when he started writing prose, poems and essays in these languages. All of his work reflects his wisdom, knowledge and philosophical ideas for his countrymen. He took help from professional tutors of that time. Among them, Sayyid Mir Hassan was one of his best teachers who portrayed an important role in Iqbal's studies. He continued to study later in his college life at Scotch Mission College in Sialkot. After that, Iqbal entered the Government College in Lahore, where he studied philosophy, English literature and Arabic and obtained a Bachelor of Arts degree. He won a gold medal for topping his examination in philosophy. While studying for his master's degree, Iqbal came under the wing of Sir Thomas Arnold. This was just not enough for him. He later went to Europe and spent many years to study arts, philosophy and law. He returned to India holding a professional degree of barrister in 1908. His return to India was meant to be a huge moral support for Muslims and cause of freedom, having a free land for the Muslims minorities. He joined All India Muslim League and became a follower of Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah in his mission.
Your Excellency, I thank His Majesty the King on behalf of the Pakistan Constituent Assembly and myself for his precious message.
Allama Iqbal was a poet and a philosopher. He is recognized as the national poet of Pakistan. He was always concerned about the thoughts, ideas, and conditions of Muslims everywhere, but especially Indian Muslims who were under British rule and also threatened by Hindu majority population. Iqbal believed strongly in Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan's earlier idea about two-nation theory, that Muslims and Hindus were two separate nations and should be allowed to live separately. He put forward this idea again in his famous Allahabad address of Muslim League in 1930 and also preached this in his poems and lectures. Allama Iqbal's words and ideas inspired many Muslims, some of whom became leaders of the Muslim League and struggled to obtain Pakistan later on. He was very popular amongst the Muslim masses too. He wrote many famous poems such as Asrar-e-Khudi, Ramuz-e-Be-Khudi, Payam-e-Mashrik, Zabur-e-Ajam, Bang-e-Dara, Bal-e-Jibril, Darb-e-Kalam, and etc. Because of his learning and knowledge, people soon began to call him Allama Iqbal. And in 1922, King George of Britain made him a knight, giving him the title of Allama Sir Muhammad Iqbal. He was awarded 5 awards. In his final years, he frequently visited the Dargah of famous Sufi Ali Hujwari in Lahore for spiritual guidance. After suffering for months from his illness, Iqbal died in Lahore on 21 April 1938. His tomb is located in Hazuri Bagh, the enclosed garden between the entrance of the Badshahi Mosque and the Lahore Fort, and official guards are provided by the Government of Pakistan. 2 years later, the Muslim League voted for the idea of Pakistan, which became a reality in 1947. He has been acclaimed as the father of Pakistan, and Iqbal Day is celebrated by Pakistanis on November 9. Personally, I have read Allama Iqbal a lot. His poetry is one of my favorite subjects to read every time. I always admire the way he motivates youth and uplifts the ambitions of Muslims. His poetry always gives us a message of freedom, peace, and unity. May Allah be pleased with him and guide us to identify the true role models of history. May our generations benefit the noor of these superheroes. Ameen, summa ameen. I hope this video is helpful for many. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay tuned for the next video. Till then, Assalamu alaikum.